Opening one's heart with joy and generosity is fundamental to living our Catholic faith.
And Catholic Charities is present and committed now for over 100 years of reaching out to people who are marginalized, who are desperate for assistance, who are looking for support.
When Quinn was laid off from her job, she and her five children quickly found themselves without a home.
Catholic Charities provided me with hope in many, many ways. To be encouraged is the biggest form of hope that you can have. I mean, it's great to know that after these months, we're going to have somewhere to live. But to know somebody supports me and that somebody is encouraging me daily, that is the best feeling in the world. When your life shuts down like that, when you lose everything that you have, you don't know which way to go. You never know how many people care until you enter a place like Catholic Charities and they let you know, don't worry, we're able to help you. It's the biggest thank you I could ever give to anybody for them to understand how big they changed someone's life.
Like most children, Nick looks forward to attending summer camp. But for a child with disabilities, the options can be very limited.
Nicholas is 12 years old, and we found Camp Happiness 2 years ago. My wife actually brought it up and said, you know, I keep hearing about this place called Camp Happiness. So I picked up the phone one day. I asked them all kinds of questions. Usually I would get the response back, sorry, we can't accommodate your son. And I was waiting for the, no, we can't. I remember hanging up the phone, called my wife and said, Joanne, we're going to Camp Happiness. We were there for about 45 minutes that first day, and when we walked out, it felt like we were walking away from a family gathering. They just took you in and made you feel at home. The best part about Camp Happiness is Nick gets to be a kid. He comes home dirty, he comes home muddy, he has a smile on his face. And that's all we can ask for.
Since childhood, faith has been central to Lewis's life. St. Augustine Health Center provides a home for Lewis, where his spiritual and physical needs are met each day.
At St. Augustine, I feel inwardly comfortable that it is a significant and solid faith-based organization. I can see it and I can feel it from the administration, and it allows me to continue to worship in my own way. The support team, doctors and aides, have made my stay here very comfortable. I had some problems. I lost a lot of weight. I went through a serious operation, and hope was kind of like out of the window. I was able to regain my appetite, and then from there, my attitude changed. And then I think I got that sparkle in my eye that said, yes, hope lives here.
For a refugee fleeing war and persecution, there is no choice but to leave their home country. Jeff is a Catholic Charities volunteer, helping people begin a new life here in Northeast Ohio.
Well, Catholic Charities is really on top of what needs to happen for a refugee. They're going to come to a country where they don't know anyone, where they don't speak the language. It's up to the Catholic Charities staff to help them in all things that are adapting to normal life in the United States. There was an Iraqi man who had been an interpreter for the United States Armed Forces. When he got to the United States, the one son was not well. We were able to take him to a neighborhood family practice where a physician was able to see the son. As I sat with the father in the waiting room, you could just see the concern that the father had, and you wanted things to go well. You wanted the son to be as well as he could possibly be as soon as possible. My religion really challenges me to not just talk about being a Christian, but really to do something about it.
My dear friends, it is my pleasure to make this appeal. It is in giving that we receive. When a person is generous, lo and behold, God is generous to that person in a different way. If you really believe that God loves us all, and He asks us to be His hands and His feet, I mean, there's nothing but joy in what you're doing because you're helping those who can't help themselves. It is the people that come to our door that are first and foremost in our lives, and we're committed to that.